Been quite a week for Siloam Springs. Yesterday, we told you about two white powder scares, one at a bank, one at a greeting card company.
Well, it happened again today, but this time it was an elementary school. 4029's Jay Plyburn is live with the latest. Jay?
For starters, we need to let you know the white powder was tested and was found to be non-toxic. In fact, it was just baking soda. But the school still had to be evacuated, and the hazmat crews were still called here to the elementary school. All is peaceful here in Siloam Springs now, except for the parents who wish they'd have gotten a call.
They didn't call us? I know they have a bunch of kids, but they should have notified the parents immediately. I would have come and got my daughter.
My parents said don't personally call here, but he went here last year. And I would have been upset if they wouldn't have called me. You know, and she's kind of upset because she said they didn't bother to contact her.
All of the parents we spoke with say they had no idea there was an evacuation, and they certainly knew nothing about a white powder scare.
We just moved here a month ago, and I absolutely love this school. And all the teachers are fantastic. The faculty is fantastic, but they kind of scares me that they didn't notify any of us.
We did not contact any parents. I guess it's word of mouth, you know, in a small community. But we did have a system for checkout for parents that arrived early and wanted their students. So we were able to check out our pre-K students on one end of the building and our kindergarten students on the other.
Cheryl Braun is the school principal, and she says they have a protocol for situations like this.
We have a written flip chart that we go through. We have crisis management books. We have a crisis bag. We have a lot of things in place so we know which avenue to take and what kind of evacuation we're going to do.
Randall Steele was working across the street as the chaos began to unfold, and like many others, he can't believe this has happened so many times recently.
I'm ready for somebody to catch whoever's doing it, because once you start threatening people at an elementary school, for goodness sakes, kindergartners, that's just way out of bounds.
Yes, it is, but you know, people are sick. People are sick. They do some strange things.
The hazmat crews were here on the scene with investigators for about an hour, but eventually the students were let back into the elementary school. If and when the person or persons responsible for all of this gets caught, they face some very serious penalties, including tampering with U.S. mail and terroristic threatening, just to name a couple. If you have any information about the people responsible, you're urged to call your local law enforcement. Craig and Angela, back to you.
All right, Jay Plyburn, live tonight in Siloam Springs. Jay, thank you for that update.